Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Mero and I teach creative people how to sell their art online. And today, we are all about how to make and sell clip art on Etsy. And when I'm looking at how to make clip art, there are like a million different things that you could be doing. There are a million types of clip arts that you can be doing, whether you're doing shapes or banners or brush strokes, or if you're doing frames or if you're doing illustrations of so many different things. And as many as there are clip art pieces that you could be making, there are also so many places where you can make them. So many softwares online or on your computer that you could be doing to make clip art, whether it's Affinity Designer, Photoshop, Canva, Clip Studio, Paint, Sui Sketches, and the list is really, really long. And even if we're looking at the massive amount of types of clip arts that you can have and the massive amount of places where you can make them, there are also a lot of different places, marketplaces, or your own store that you can sell clip art. Whether you want to sell clip art for someone to use for a personal purpose, like making scrapbooking and stuff like that, or whether you want to do clip art that people can use for professional reasons, for commercial use, there are so many different places that you can sell it. You can sell your clip art on Etsy with your own Etsy store. You can sell your clip art on PayHip, on LaunchCart, because they do have the download option, like the digital download product options. You can sell it on marketplaces like Creative Market or Creative Fabrica, or even just have your own Shopify store to sell it, or your own WordPress store to sell it. So there are really a lot of places. And I do believe that if I dive deeper into this topic, we can make like what? 20, 30 videos on this topic of how to make and sell clip art, whether different types of clip art, different ways of making them, and different places of selling them. But for this tutorial, and just for this one, because it's the first one of what I think would be a very long clip art series in this channel, I am going to be focusing on selling this on Etsy, and I am going to be focusing on making it with Clip Studio Paint, which is a software that I'm personally using. And I know that a lot of you have been looking into Clip Studio Paint because of some of the videos, but a lot of the things that I do on Clip Studio Paint can also be done with Photoshop. For the majority of this tutorial, I am going to use my Wacom Intuos tablet, which I love very, very much, and my little trusted pen, just to make life easier for me in case, you know, I want to do brush strokes and I want to do something with watercolors and I want to do something with spray paint. And the reason why I chose what I'm going to do today as the first system that I'm presenting is because this is a very easy way to just create really unique graphics really fast. And the way that I'm usually doing it is by finding different types of shapes on Canva, just, you know, a heart and a circle and a square, and then sort of painting within them, making something cool, doing like gradient lights. And it's super easy to do it with Clip Studio Paint as well as with other designer softwares like Photoshop. So in a minute, I'm going to take you to my computer. We're going to go to Canva. We're going to look into these shapes. We're going to download them, upload them onto Clip Studio Paint, where I'm going to show you what I do with them there. But then I'm also going to save them, upload them again to Canva to create the photos you need in order to sell them on Etsy, as well as create a full Etsy listing with all the details like the tags and the name and the description that you will need to sell your clip art on Etsy. As for how to sell it, in terms of professional or commercial use, there are so many different things that you can do. You can flat out say that this is for personal use only. Create a listing that is just for personal use. And if someone wants to use it in a commercial way, they can purchase another listing, which is the license, to be using that in a commercial way. Or you could say that there is a minimal commercial use also included. So for example, if you're selling clip art of dogs and you say like a limited commercial use, so people can use it within their Instagram or with like a business banner or something like that, but they cannot sell it on product. Or you can just flat out say, hey, you can use it for commercial purposes, whether you want to do print on demand as is or with changes, and just decide on what you want to do. And this is a very, very personal decision. Whenever I was looking into this topic, I was always thinking to myself, you can't really control it. I mean, someone can purchase clip art from you for personal use and they live in Japan and they're going to take it to a store, make a bunch of paintings with it and then sell it in a physical store and you'll never know. And they can also put it on Redbubble and you might even never know as well. So that's why I think that I like to just say that my things are approved for commercial purposes, and I think that it's also good for the audience. And when I take you to my Etsy store, I think I have to clarify something. This is not really my Etsy store. I mean, this is an Etsy store that I sort of started when I started making tutorials because I wanted, you know, an Etsy store to upload stuff into. And I'm always like trying to think about what I want to do with this Etsy store. I really wanted to transform it into print on demand to sell puzzles. Now I'm not so sure because I had a problem with the supplier I wanted to work with. And I'm actually, I always had this thought in my mind to use that Etsy store to sell clip art for commercial purposes. Please let me know if that's something that is interesting to you. If you would like to have some of my own clip art that you can purchase with, like, you know, just a few dollars, so you can use it on Redbubble and stuff like that. So without further ado, I'm going to take you to my computer and let's get started with this tutorial. But don't forget to come back to me after that, because we do have a lot to discuss on this topic, as well as what we have in store for us for the end of the month and for September.
So we're going to start with Canva, and that's something that I like doing just to get my shapes in order. And I'm using 3600 by 3600 pixels. This is a size that I prefer to use. And I'm going to go to Elements, and I'm going to look into Lines and Shapes. And I'm going to do something very basic right now. I mean, come on, who cannot make a circle shape? I mean, why would anyone want to buy a circle shape from you, or a square shape? I mean, those are pretty basic and people can pretty much find them everywhere. But I'm going to take all of these shapes. We have the triangle, we have the square, the circle, and I'm going to take a lot more, and we're going to transform them in so many different ways. And it's going to be super easy, to be honest. I mean, the system I have to show you right now will make your life super easy. If you have Clip Studio Paint, I reckon you can also do the same with Photoshop and with a lot of different editing softwares. I just work with Clip Studio Paint because, you know, I kind of like them. And I'm looking into all of these very free shapes, and we're going to transform all of them into a completely different thing. And it's going to be so easy. And I'm trying to find more interesting shapes that I want to be using, or more shapes that I think other people might need to use, no matter what it is that they're creating or they're making. I don't even know what I'm going to do with it yet, but I'm keeping some of these shapes in. We also have some nice frames here that people might want to use. We also have this shape here, this banner. And it doesn't really matter what are the shapes that I'm taking now, as long as once you do it for yourself, you're going to stay consistent within the shapes that you're making or the things that you're doing. So right now I have 9 shapes, and I'm going to download all of them as is. And usually I download them with a transparent background, but for the sake of this tutorial, I don't need to use a transparent background. So this is also an option for people who are not using Canva Pro. Although, you know, Canva Pro is one of the best tools that I've ever used, and it's helping me a lot. So I think that it is worth the investment, but, you know, let's just start off without it. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to select all of them and open all of them in Clip Studio Paint. Now, they all opened up on different files. Let me just quickly go about it. This is my first one. And what I'm going to do is click on the no color and click on my paint option to basically delete the background of each and every one of these shapes. And basically what I'm going to do is pretty much the same option for each and every one of the layers, which is here. If you can see this part, clip to layer below. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a new layer. And let's say I'm holding on the pink, and I'm going to go to oil paint, and I'm just going to color. And this is on a layer on top of here. I'm just going to color everything. I'm just going to color everything with oil color. And as you can see, this is a bit of a transparent oil paint. Just going to color everything. And I can also have some variety in my colors. Just go over the places where it's a bit transparent. I don't want anything to look transparent at all. Let's just take another one and just make a mishmash of things. And I'm going to go to my first layer, and I'm going to color this one in white. Obviously, I could have done it from Canva, but, you know, let's just go all over them to color them in white. You can also color them in black or in different colors. It doesn't make a difference if the layer above it is not see-through, but I like to have, you know, a clean board. And activate this layer and clip it in. Now we have a perfect circle. And if I take the same layer and I'm going to copy and paste it, which is Ctrl V, Ctrl C, it basically creates the same thing all over the place. And this is, again, Command V or Control V, depends on the laptop that you are using. Another thing that I can do is add another layer. And this layer, this time, will be colored with watercolor. Let's go with watercolor, paint and apply. A little bit big. And let's just go a little bit all over the place. Let's find a different color to blend it with. And a darker one. And let's go with a light blue here. And a bit of a darker blue. And again, clip this one on. And I can copy paste it to be on all of the others. But there are actually easier things that I can do. Let's add a new layer here. And with this layer, what I'm going to do is I'm going to color all of it in blue. And then I'm going to select the white color and go to the effects that I actually have within Clip Studio Paint. So I have a glittering effect for sparkles. Let's make it a bit bigger. And the sparkle particles are extremely small. So let's undo this. Go to the settings of my sparkles. Make this particle size bigger. And sparkle all around. And then clip to the layer below, and we have this. You can go to this one, delete this one, get a new layer, choose a different color. And let's check out some more of my effects here, like the heart color one. And these are actually colored. These are little hearts, colored and beautiful and cute. Little colors, and let's just spray them all over the place. Or again, change the particle size this way, and let's just go all over the place and blend it down to a square. Let's choose a different shape. Let's go with a heart. Where's my heart? Sounds funny when I say, you know what, let's go with a star. Add a new layer, and we're going to explore a little bit of what we have in here. So again, I'm going to choose a color for everything. I'm going to go to white, go back to my effects, and you have flowers here. So I have these flowers in here, which are kind of nice, which are a combination of two colors. So as you can see, it's a combination of two different colors. And let's go with cosmos flowers, or I want to find something cute. We have poppy flowers. I think that I had the lilies here that are quite unique, and I'm just tapping here to create all of these amazing, insane lilies all over the place. Just tapping everywhere. To the point where it doesn't even matter that the color behind it or below it was pink. But what I can also do is go back to the black settings, choose a pink one, click on the white again, make the lilies smaller, and then spray those lilies on top of it, just all over the place. This is actually a beautiful digital paperback. I don't know if you've seen the video on how to make and sell digital paperbacks on Etsy or anywhere else. But this could actually be a really, really awesome digital paper pack. I can do this again. And this time, let's choose something blue. And make the size of the lilies smaller. Don't forget to click back on the white to have the outer frame. Basically, the two-tone color combination. Tapping it all over the place. This is actually a very beautiful design that I'm thinking about doing for Redbubble right now. But that will probably be on a different video. And again, what I'm going to do is clip it to the bottom, and we have an amazing star. I can also do it again with this one. Where is my heart? Oh, there is my heart. Let's continue working on the heart with something that is the most basic and simplest to do with Clip Studio Paint, because we sort of have this way of filling things. This is called the gradient effect. And the gradient effect, first of all, we have the rainbow. So for example, if I take this line and just put a line here, everything is going to be rainbowed, and then I can take it down. The thing is that I can edit these rainbows. I can edit pretty much all the gradients here. For example, sunset, it's not the traditional sunset colors, as you can see. It's colors that I've changed and adapted because they are what I wanted. And I can go in, add a new layer, and just go into the properties of the sunset and choose different colors for all of these. Let's go with green. This one, I can go with another green. Let's just do a green gradient through and through. And of course, the first one, which was purplish. And choose this one. Then go here, color all of this, and merge it down. Let's go to another layer and try something else. We also have the night sky option, which is again the colors chosen from the system. We have the photosphere, which is actually sort of a circle that we're bringing in. We can bring it in multiple times in the same one, create these beautiful spheres all over the place. We can edit their colors. Sort of like dreamland material, guys. Let's do another one. This is a lot like the original color. And this is why it's important that the back layer is going to be white, because it makes my life easier. And I'm going to clip it to the bottom layer and create this heart. Another thing that I can do is basically combine several of the things that I've done here. So if I have the blue sky and I can stretch them all over the place, what I can do is I can select the white color after that, go back to my effects. Let's say I have patterns here of stars, of hearts. I have all these kind of trees and like grass that I can put in all over the place. We have this grass effect. We have the fallen leaves effect. And we have a lot of different types of things. We actually also have like rubble. These are like just sort of like concrete, as well as all these kind of cool lines, sand. I do like these lines though, and I do want to make them a tiny bit bigger, like this. Or have the clouds. We have all kinds of rulers that we can use, like that. Let's try clipping this one down. This will make a very interesting heart. But I can also go with my spray feature on it and do something like this, which would make a nice heart. And as much as I'm doing this for everything, one thing that I can do is actually have this heart, for example, and I'm using the spray paint again. But I'm going to go to a new layer, go back to my gradient effects, and change these properties to, let's say, a dark green. Then we have here again, going to the same place with green. Selecting this, opening a new layer, editing the colors. Let's go with sort of like magenta or purplish pink. And I'm going to spray paint on top of them, the same way. And always make sure that my heart is below. Let's take this one below, activate this layer, spray on top of it, and do the same thing. And what I want to do is obviously save these, because otherwise, you know, I'm going to save them, for example, with a transparent background, and make sure that you're saving them with PNG. And what I can do is either have a clip art set, for example, of, you know, just the circles, a million different types of circles that people might like. Let's take up this one here. We have all the things that we've done on the heart that are also adorable that we can copy paste to be on our circle. And you can sell a variety of different circles. For example, let's take our rainbow layer. And you can sell a bunch of different circles as clip art. But what you can also do is, let's say we have this effect of the spray and the blue. I can take this spray in the blue and sell it as a circle, as a square, as a triangle, as all of the other shapes. I need to put it above it. All of the other shapes that we have here, and create a set that is this way. What I can also add to this set, other than the fact that we have a 3600 by 3600 pixel, by creating a new file, and that file is not going to be in the same sizes. That file is going to be in the same width, but the height is going to be lower because I'm creating brush strokes. So what I'm going to do, after first of all having this layer here as well on top of everything, which is this layer, is go back to this layer, my new layer down above, down below. I'm going to go to my paints, and I'm going to try to look in, like, for example, oil paint. So we have thin oil paint, which, if I'm going to choose a color, let's just make sure that my layer is clear, because I kind of messed it up with a little bit of white on it. Let's find a different brush stroke. Let's say this one. Delete the background, go up top, and merge this layer in to have a brush stroke of this color. And again, I can also take one of the other layers and tap it in and create multiple brush strokes. And this is by far the easiest way to create unique clip art, something that is special for you. And I know that for a lot of people, when you talk about clip art, a lot of people think about illustrations, but the fact is that the majority of people are really looking to find good brush strokes, something to brand them, something with good color palettes. And as long as you can play around with these colors and create like a set of some sort, you're going to have a smashing success. And if I'm talking about taking it to the next level, if I want to list things up on Etsy, and I'm going to do it with the brush strokes, or I'm just thinking, you know, maybe let's make a full set out of it. I'm not sure. I do like this whole like sparkling night kind of thing that we have, but I do also like the brush strokes as an idea for my shapes, or maybe just do hearts because, you know, Valentine's Day and stuff like that. So what I'm looking into right now is just to create a little folder of some clip art that I can sell on Etsy. So I can show you how to make a cute little mock-up, basically not just a mock-up, but how to present it to other people. So let's just quickly save this, and I'm going to go to my downloads folder and create a new folder and call it tutorial clip art and save this one as blue heart. And it's important that when you're selling clip art, you actually use good names for the clip art, because people are going to see the names of the files. So we have blue heart saved. But we also have this heart, and we're going to save it as a new file as pink heart. We also have the green heart. We have flower heart. And I do want to make some easy ones here. So let me just grab these layers. I'm not going to need them. Get them out of my way. Add a new layer. Go here. Let's go with Indian ink, one of my favorite ones. and just paint all over this. And I'm not liking this one bit. Maybe let's go with watercolors. Those are always better in my eyes. Let's just make a beautiful watercolor heart. Save it. Let's change it up a bit. Red watercolor heart. This came off sort of like blue purplish. I just want to go over it really strong to make sure that it's just the blue. And one more thing that I like to be doing is going back to these where we have stripes. And these stripes are usually of two different colors. So I'm going to go to this. Let's choose, for example, this type of color and just stretch it a little bit. And we have two awesome colors. Let's stretch it a little bit more. And notice that the angle of how I'm stretching it, as well as how far I'm stretching it, determines the repetitiveness. And obviously the color below, I can also adapt that one, for example here, and then with this layer go on to this one, change it a bit, and have this go to the layer below, choose this color, go to the layer above. And I can actually manually color these once the stripes have been made. And let's just make more of these. Let's color the heart in purple, in pink, add a new layer, go here, go back to my stripes, change the color, change the angle. We have red stripes hot. And let's go to another layer. Go back to my heart, color it in black. Go back to my layer. Do yellow, for example. And do something like this or like this. I want to do something really straight. Not that straight. Kind of look like prison with these colors. Or like a bee. Yeah, a bee would be better than prison for sure. And I have all these hearts now saved. And I can go into my files. Let's go to my downloads where I saved it. And we have basically 10 hearts saved, which is enough for me to show you how to create mockups for Etsy. And for that, I'm going to go back to Canva, go back to home. And there is usually a standard size that I'm using for most of my Etsy tutorials, for most of my Etsy featured photos, which is 2454 by 2020 pixels. I'm just going to take all of these hearts and drop them here. Obviously, if you want to make a nicer set, like if you want to make the colors make more sense, be better together, you can also do that. But, you know, I'm just getting started here. And what is important to me while this one is loading up is to have a way to show people what I'm doing. And I basically need at least 5 photos for Etsy to show them that I'm selling clip art, what are the sizes of the clip art, and what they can do about it. So if I'm quickly going into one of these watercolor hearts just to see what are the actual sizes of what I created at the end, and I created 3500 by 3100. These are the sizes of the heart, approximately, of all the hearts. And when I'm doing these things, it's really important to keep in mind your own branding, the colors of your store. And as you know, we're not talking about a current store right now. Let's just try to think about something that would look good, like if you're just starting out. So I'm going to take a shape because everything starts with a shape, and I'm going to put it here. And I was thinking of maybe even making it white. And for the rest of the background, I'm going to choose something else, something different for everything that I'm going to do. And on this line at the bottom, I'm basically writing down what I'm selling, which is, in this case, is clip art set 10 hearts. And of course, this should be also in the font of your store, the font of your branding and how you present it. Let's say, kind of like these fonts that I got from Creative Fabrica. They're pretty awesome. But this one, yeah, I kind of really like this one. I just think I need to maybe open it up a bit. And here you can also designate if it's for personal use, for commercial use. So for example, I can add another piece of text here in the secondary font of your business. Usually I like combining cursive fonts with like normal fonts. Let's say I want to do it for commercial use. And I know that a lot of people are like, how can I prevent people from using my designs for commercial purposes? Well, you can't. You can find them when they're doing it and you can try to sue them, ask them to take it down, talk to the platform, but you can never actually really stop it, which is why I always prefer that if I'm selling anything online that is a graphic file, I'm going to allow it to be used for commercial purposes. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to go back to my uploads and basically click on all of these hearts to be placed here. Let's grab all of them, make them a bit smaller so I can basically place them all over the place. Like, let's say I'm doing it like that. Grab both of these and take them to back because they're kind of stepping on this. And yeah, it might not look as good as you thought it would be. It might take some time for you guys to find out how you want to style yourselves, how you want to present things, and, you know, change the color of the background here to make it a bit more visible, to make it more easy for other people. You can also change the entire color of the entire background to be something gradient. That would be easier for me to showcase what I'm selling. Let's try a different gradient color. I kind of like the yellow ones. Sending this one back to white, or this one to black with these in white. And I can also minimize this if I want to make sure that people see everything. But the thing is that it's very important that you will have some of them like touching each other, so people cannot just go in and grab this without paying you and just start using them without paying you. Let's maybe try to change the gradient a bit and really work on a color that specifically is suitable for the type of designs that I'm selling here. I think this would be nice, even though it's incredibly dark. The second thing I can do for this tutorial is basically to explain the sizes. So for example, I'm going to take one heart, place it here, grab this piece of text and write down. So our down size is approximately 3500 by 3100 pixels each, PNG files with transparent background, 10 files included with 10 heart illustrations in different colors. And if I don't want to have people being able to use this heart, I can just make it bigger and send it to the back like that. Let's make it even bigger. As you remember, the original file size is huge. I can duplicate this, put the heart on the other side, and this is again with every shape that you're doing. Let's choose a different one. I do want to choose a dark one a bit because we have the text here that's going to overlay. Maybe this one. So let's go with the blue one so I can still see this. And this is where I determine what kind of a commercial thing people can do with it. So in my book, again, I'm always going for the full commercial. And this is usually what I like to write. So the use is for personal, for art projects, scrapbooking, making awesome gifts. Commercial can be used in the making of any physical product you're selling as is, as well as combined with printable or digital items, cannot be sold as clip art. That's what I would like to be writing here. Obviously, you can write something a bit different if you want. I can also style this a bit different. Let's bring the heart like in here. If I don't want it to get in my way, delete the word uses, space these up a bit tiny bit more. Grab this one. And I can also show people what they can do with these hearts. So for example, I'm going to go quickly to place it where I have a world of amazing mockups. And let's do like mud mockup. Click on the first one I'm looking at. Insert one of the images of the hearts. Let's choose for the mug this heart, for example. Crop it out. Put it on the heart. Let's resize it a bit to make it a bit smaller. To put it on the mug. And change the mug color into black. That is kind of nice. I kind of like it with this one. I don't know why. Let's download this photo and upload it onto Canva. I'm going to duplicate this. Take this photo, place it here, send it to back, make this one smaller, and change the text for example, once again, change my mind, delete the word for example, and take it for this one. We can also have this, and we have 1, 2, 3, and 4 items. And what I like to do with pretty much everything, if you're selling on Etsy, have a fifth photo that is just a thank you. And here, just write your name, write down graphic designer, and change this up to a photo of me. Do I have photos of me? I'm sure I have a lot of photos of me on Canva. I should. For example, this photo. And in this case, what I wrote down, thank you for checking out my clip art. I hope it'll give you hours of making awesome designs. If you have any questions, feel free to contact me through my Etsy shop or IG, which is Instagram, Mei Aroyo. And these would be the photos that we're going to be using. So let's just download them. And we don't have to use PNG formats here. We can just download JPEG files of 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 photos. Well, obviously, going to Etsy. And I don't know how much of you have been following my journey through Etsy, but my journey through Etsy has been very long, mostly trying to figure out what I want to sell, reactivating some stuff, deactivating some stuff. Really, like, I think that whenever I'm making a tutorial, I kind of want to go ahead and sell it. But I'm really thinking about trying to focus my efforts with selling clip art because I just like making clip art so much. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a new listing, add photos, go to my downloads where I downloaded all of these, grab all of them. And the first thing that I need to think about is a title. So this is, what am I selling? Because right now, the first thing that I know I'm selling is 10 hearts clip art set. However, if someone is looking for commercial use license, that would be the first thing that they will be looking for. So I'm actually going to start with that. So what I wrote down is commercial use okay clip art of hearts, gradient hearts clip art, print on demand approved graphics, and 10 hearts clip art set. Who made it? I did. What it is? Finished product. When did I make it? Well, right now. And the category is clip art. They actually have a category for this. This is for card making, for collages, for kids craft, for scrapbooking. This is abstract and geometric. We have all of these categories where you can choose basically what it is. I'm pretty much sure that we also have something like love and friendship, which I'm also gonna mark because, you know, it's a heart. And the length. I can choose the sizes in centimeters, feet, inches, meters, and millimeters, which is not pixels, so I'm not gonna choose a size here. Although I can pretty much set it up to be like 10 inches, but I can just leave it blank. No primary color is here, no secondary color because, you know, they're all multiple colors. And the occasion for this time, you don't have to mark these up, but it's good. I will probably do something like an anniversary for the occasion. And a holiday, I would choose Valentine's Day. Do I have? Yes. Because, you know, it's hearts. And of course, that this is a digital file, which is the most important part. And now we're coming into the description. So let me just quickly think about something to write. Okay, so Rutta wrote down here, looking for a cute set of hearts clip art? Check out this 10 hearts clip art set of hearts in gradient and sparkling colors. This set includes 10 hearts all in different colors, as you can see in the first image. It's a digital file, no physical product will be shipped to you. And then on what you're getting, again, the same thing that we wrote down, 10 PNG files with transparent background and the size, personal use, describing commercial use, prohibited uses, and if you have any question for me, please let me know through the Etsy message system or contact me through Instagram, which is what I prefer. Obviously, if you prefer, like, I don't know, Facebook, can go ahead and do that. And the last thing that I need is to grab all of these and compress them into one zip file, because I cannot add 10 files onto Etsy and call this parts clip art, for example, if this is, you know, if I only have one, and work on my sections. Section for this would be hearts clip art, or if you're just selling clip art, it really depends on how your store is aligned. And the tags would be, again, starting with commercial use okay. So what I wanna write down is commercial use okay, hearts clip art, gradient hearts, Valentine's Day art, Valentine's Day heart, graphics for sale, hearts, graphics, clip art set, clip art bundle, clip art shapes, shapes, clip art, and notice that one time I write clip art separately and one time connected because people are using both commercial clip art and print on demand. And then obviously you can price it up. I'm pricing it up in shekels, and I'm not going to get into how much you should price it up. It's your decision. You're the ones who know how long it takes you to make these items. You're the ones who know the value of them. And as well as, you know, you're the ones who know what kind of sales you want to have in your store. And the quantity of a digital item, I always try to do 100 for it because, you know, it's a lot, and upload the file that I actually took here, the zip file, and publish this to my store. And let's go ahead and check it out. Not by stats, obviously, I just uploaded this now, but let's go and check it out on Etsy. And I'm thinking I might want to start actually going back to this Etsy store that I set up, I think it was when I started this channel in January, just to use it to upload some stuff onto it in tutorials. But I'm starting to think that I might start taking it more seriously and actually sell my clip art here, because I do have a lot of clip art made throughout these various videos, and it is a fun and easy thing to do. And with that pop finish, I'm gonna get back to me, and I'm gonna talk to you more about clip art, because there are so many other things that we can do. And if this is something that is interesting to you, we're going to start sort of like a mini series within this channel about how to make clip art of various kinds, as well as other places to sell clip art that are not Etsy.
And we're back to me. And I hope that you guys enjoyed this quick little tutorial. And, you know, first of all, if you did, please hit that like button down below, because every time we do, YouTube thinks, hey, this is a cool video, I'm gonna show it to more people. And subscribe to my channel if you are not yet subscribed. But really, I do hope that you enjoyed this system. And even if you don't wanna sell clip art, there are so many things that you could be doing just by making this clip art. For example, I took my clip art, I took two of these hearts already this morning and uploaded them onto Redbubble. I put them on items like the desk mat, which is pretty cool. And again, it's a new product on Redbubble, so go ahead and check it out. It even looks good on a hat. And I really liked how it just looked on all kinds of products, even the stickers or the postcards. It was just super easy to make and super easy to upload. This whole topic of making and selling clip art, again, you can make the clip art for yourself to combine with your print on demand. I could have taken all of these hearts and turned them into printable stickers on Etsy, or print on demand stickers on Etsy or on Shopify. I could have turned them into stationery packs. I could have placed them on printable greeting cards or physical greeting cards. And I can also develop the idea of selling commercially use approved clip art by also adding to the store things like the brush strokes, the frames, but also digital paper packs, which we've had a full tutorial just about that, because that will sort of create a store that has like the overall solution for all these kind of, you know, graphic elements. There is also big importance in making clip art that is text, and there are so many things, amazing things that you could do with text combinations and, you know, a little bit of shadow here and there, graffiti effects. And I am looking forward to making more and more videos about creating your own clip art, whether it is to sell it on Etsy, whether it is to sell it on Shopify or on Payhip, or whether it will be just, you know, to make your own clip art so you can use it for Redbubble and for other print-on-demand avenues. I will be seeing you guys in 3 days from now with a very special video because, well, it's a video that you have chosen, in which I'm going to take new acrylic colors that I got from Fabrica A and I'm going to use them to actually paint a physical abstract acrylic painting. Then I'm going to photograph that painting and then I'm going to make a pattern from it to be uploaded onto Redbubble and other print-on-demand websites. And this is a really unique system and I'm looking into really diving deeper into this topic because I don't want to just use Redbubble. I also want to be using either Society6 or Art of Wear as examples from what you can do with this because there are amazing things that you can do. And I'm also thinking for September, a video that I really wanted to do, how to create patterns from brush strokes, as well as a video that you guys have requested repeatedly in the past few videos, which is just a special video just on the making of seamless patterns. But our month of September will start, as usual, with the 1st of September, being me talking about my goals for the month of September, my goals for the last quarter of 2021, because I don't know if you've been following my monthly goals, but my main goal is to reach some sort of stable passive income for 2022 throughout 2022. So this is the last quarter of 2021. This is money time, guys. And I will be talking about my goals for September, my goals for the fourth quarter, as well as have I met my goals for August. And I think it will be fun. I think that throughout these months, I keep being surprised that people are watching the goals videos. I didn't think that people would find a lot of value in them, but I think that even though they're not as watched as other tutorials, I'm getting a lot of feedback, especially on DMs from people who have seen them and then said, you know what, I'm going to do the same. I'm going to have monthly goals. I'm going to stick to my goals. And I'm also going to be forgiving to myself if I miss out on a goal or two or all of them here and there. I would love to hear your opinions about all of these topics that we discussed, so feel free to comment them down below. I'm actually even like consulting with you guys, thinking about opening, like making this Etsy store designated for clip art and for things that you could use for print on demand, for commercial purposes. Let me know if that is something that is interesting for you guys. And I'm also always looking for people to review in shop review videos, which will start again in the next month. Redbubble, Society6, Etsy, Payhip, Shopify, wherever it is that you're selling printable or print-on-demand items. And with that being said, that was it from me for today. Thank you so much for watching. And as usual, see you guys in my next video. Bye!